Shit.
I don't know how to describe this dude.
Milton is a different breed, man. I've never really seen anything like it.
All he wants is speed and like bombing hills and like ripping carnage.
I mean, you could be standing here talking to somebody and he creeps off and all of a sudden you hear like someone bombing a hill that he's never even like looked at the road before, and it's like, what the fuck? You just gotta keep your eye on him.
Ever worked with someone as fucking heavy as Milton Martinez.
He's a skate rat.
He's just trying to go fast.
Dude, car wash, man. It is iconic, legendary, steep bank, big roof, busy street. Not many people have been able to conquer it. Cars and Guns, the ones that fucking broke the ice.
We had come from SF to do some filming with Mark, and he like took us to the car wash, and it was just like so gnarly, but I was feeling it, and like I didn't want to like step on his toes because obviously it was Mark's spot. I was like, hey Mark, fucking, if I give this a shot, man, will you at least go for it? And he was like, yep, because he was over it. He was done. He was like, let's go. I gave it a shot, fucking made it. And Mark fucking took the slam, and we sucked.
And nothing's gone successful. And since fucking Greco ollied it.
That's why it's the car wash and the spot, because the people that skated it. It makes the spot like a legendary spot, and I'm fucking super honored that I can be a little part of that. You know, it's insane. The first time that I went there, it was while filming for the Holy Stokes video, which that was like my first video that I was gonna be in. And Travis was like, I asked Dustin if he's so good like with going to the spot and try the kickflip, because he tried to before me. And he said he's so good, I was like, fuck. I went there, got there 6 in the morning, and it was super crazy. You know, it was just like, I wasn't ready to do it, and I try it anyways because I thought to myself I was gonna try it. And I don't know, the second or third ollie that I try, I broke my feet super bad.
Oh, I broke my foot.
And that was the end of the video part. But you know, that's how it goes.
I didn't think he was ever gonna go back, and I don't know why you would.
Yeah, I wasn't really thinking about like, oh, the first thing that I wanna do when I get back on skating is like car washing. But Rhino was like, hey, I'm going to LA to shoot this ad with Henry if you want to cruise. And I wanted to check the car wash just to check Shake Phelps' tag. And I got there, we saw it was like fucking the whole bank. And it was like, fuck, you know, I gotta get out there now. Like, I guess I was like just thinking about Phelps and just go for it, you know, like.
I just had my phone out and you just ollied into it, like, got past that fucking crazy horror fucking story, you know, breaking your leg there, and you just overcame that. He climbed back up on the roof, and then he's like, oh, I'm gonna try one kickflip. And I was like, oh shit, like, still don't have my camera shit, like, who knows, he might make it first try or whatever.
I guess he got me really high. I was like, fuck it, you know, if I break my leg again, it has to be now, when he says Shake Phelps on it, you know? So I tried one, it was like super sketchy, and I was like, all right, I gotta come back, you know.
He wanted to get the kickflip before Shake's name got painted over from the owner, you know. That kind of sparked the whole fucking thing.
He went on a few trips, or went on maybe a Volcom trip or something. He was gone for like a week and a half or something. And then he hit me up and he's like, hey, I'm back. Like, let's fucking go try to get this kickflip. Pull up, they're still washing cars. And we're just kind of sitting across the street. Milton's getting antsy. Finally, like, they start closing up and then everyone leaves. And then it's like, all right, get the wood. Start setting it all up and then get ready for the kickflip.
I don't know, for some reason that day was like super hectic and you gotta wait for everything, and at the same time you're trying to clear your mind to commit the kickflip.
That block is hot. It's like fucking Sunset Boulevard. You got foot traffic going by you. They see a dude up on the roof. Cars are fucking stopping. People have got their iPhones out. They're like, what's going on, you know? And Milton's up on the roof fucking trying to watch the lights. And then he starts trying to kickflip.
Oh.
The kickflip was working and I was trying and I was running out of it, but I was too scared on my mind to commit, you know, because the one that I break my leg, it was like pretty gnarly and I was freaking out. But if there was a time to try to go for it, it was that one.
It's fucking crazy. Just caught one, put it down right where the bank hits the sidewalk, and he gets spun out and pitched into the street, and he's just like, what the fuck, you know what I mean? And I'm just like, you're fucking rolling away. And we were looking at the footage, and he thought he broke his finger's bleeding and stuff. Right where the bank meets the sidewalk, there's a crack. It had dirt and shit in it, you know, so it didn't look like it would affect him. But I guess when his wheel rolled across it, it sunk in a little bit and just like pitched him, just enough to get him off his board and throw him in the street. He thought he was fucking done, you know what I mean? He got back up there for another one and just, it was a shitty kickflip and he was just fingers bleeding. He's just like bummed. So we ended, he's like, I gotta come back.
Yeah, that one got me. But I was just like, you know, I gotta fucking do it. You know, this shit has to happen somehow.
So I'm like, I want to get this done like soon. I knew he was going on a Volcom trip in a week to New York City. So I just hit him up like, hey dude, you want to try to get this before you go to New York? And he's just like, yeah, I'm down, when? So we ended up the same mission. This time we got like 3 carloads of dudes going up there.
At first there was heavy jam up. He just started ollieing into it and then he kickflipped in from just the top. And whatever, people that work there start freaking out.
And then all of a sudden, like 4 cop cars fucking pull in. The owner called the cops because of Milton and everybody else hanging out, like he knew we were gonna skate the roof, you know? I was like, fuck it, dude. I'm just gonna run across the street, fucking slap the Bondo on the spot that fucked him up. Milton grabs his board. The wood's already up on the roof from the first kickflip attempt. And I'm like, dude, we're good. Because the cops pulled out and went the other way. And then it just started going again.
I don't know how there were so many cop cars. Like, cop cars kept on coming by. We're like, lay down. So like, he would just lay down on the roof. And then Frex was like pointing the opposite way as a diversion. Cops are staring at us, looking the opposite way, not looking at Milton.
To be honest, I don't remember any of that shit. I just remember trying to get my mind to commit the fucking one kickflip. One more time, just like what it came to my mind is like watching all the fucking homies' faces. That was the reason that, you know, I was up there and like everyone was like, all right, like you fucking got this shit, like you got it. All right, fucking, if you guys say so.
Kickflip perfect, took it into the bank, and then I think his feet blew off like when he got to the curb and he like fell into the gutter. It was a good slam, but he was fine. He got up really quick. He was pretty unfazed.
You can see it in his face, though. He's just grinning like, yep, today's the day, I got it.
Holy fucking hell! I think, yeah, 7 or 8 tries later, he ended up doing it. And I swear the one that he did, kickflip catch, and I just, on the catch, I just called it. I was like, yep! Oh.
Yep.
Hey, fuck you. Yeah, he just took it in, no problem. And I swear, if you didn't see any of the tries or like knew like what he'd gone through prior to getting that kickflip, it looked so fucking easy, the one that he did.
I just remember like going across the street. I mean, like, okay, it's fucking over. That's it. Fuck. We can keep it going, but this one's gone. But yeah, having everyone there, it was like,
thank you guys.
This is what skateboarding is about, you know, like having all the homies. And just can't wait to smoke that banger and drink a beer with everyone, you know. So thankful, you know, for everything, how it went down, and like, I got no words. So much love in skateboarding, you know. It's a big family, it's that. It's for real that. So it's good to keep it that way. We should keep it that way.